first of all, we're very grateful to the United Church of Canada for that relation of support during very difficult times for our church and for our country. It's a changing moment for Cuba, I think, a very challenging moment for Cuba. I think it's good in a way because, well, the United States is our neighbor. The embargo, or the blockade, as we call it, will end, and that will give new economical possibilities for our people. But at the same time, it's a big challenge. And the churches are in the middle of that because religion has been an instrument of liberation, but it has been an instrument of domination. And many conservative, I would say fundamentalist, churches in the United States are coming to Cuba with a neo-colonial perspective. Sometimes they are unconscious. They don't have it on the, as a goal, but it's true. For example, for the children in Sunday schools, no? Our drawing of Jesus is a mulatto, but now they're bringing materials with Jesus blonde and blue eyes. It's an expression of the cultural impact of that. So it's a challenge because they say they're going to teach us how to preach the gospel. We have been preaching the gospel for 50 years in our church. And I always say Jesus Christ didn't leave Cuba during that time. It was living in Cuba through the witness of the churches. Theological education can help us to at least stop and to maintain our own identity as Christians in Cuba. So I think that's a new big challenge for us. And in that perspective, I think the relations with the United Church of Canada and our brothers and sisters in Canada is very important because it can bring a balance of that. And we need your help. We need your support. We need your solidarity. And we need that you are with us as you have been all these years.